Webb's two new targets. With its mirror segments beautifully aligned and its scientific instruments undergoing calibration, NASA's James Webb Space Telescope is just weeks away from full operation. Soon after the first observations are revealed this summer, Webb's in-depth science will begin. Among the investigations planned for the first year are studies of two hot exoplanets, classified as super-Earths for their size and rocky composition, the lava-covered 55 Cancri E and the airless LHS-3844b. Researchers will train Webb's high-precision spectrographs on these planets, with a view to understanding the geologic diversity of planets across the galaxy and the evolution of rocky planets like Earth. 55 Cancri E, an exoplanet approximately 40.71 light-years from the Earth, or about 239,318 billion miles from Earth. About 8.63 Earth masses, and diameter about twice that of the Earth. 55 Cancri E orbits less than 1.5 million miles from its sun-like star, 1/25th of the distance between Mercury and the Sun, completing one circuit in less than 18 hours. With surface temperatures far above the melting point of typical rock-forming minerals, the dayside of the planet is thought to be covered in oceans of lava. Planets that orbit this close to their star are assumed to be tidally locked, with one side facing the star at all times. As a result, the hottest spot on the planet should be the one that faces the star most directly, and the amount of heat coming from the dayside should not change much over time. 55 Cancri E could have a thick atmosphere dominated by oxygen or nitrogen, explained Renyu Hu of NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Southern California, who leads a team that will use Webb's near-infrared camera, NIRCam, and mid-infrared instrument, MIRI, to capture the thermal emission spectrum of the dayside of the planet. If it has an atmosphere, Webb has the sensitivity and wavelength range to detect it and determine what it is made of. LHS-3844b. LHS-3844, also known as this, is a red dwarf star located 48 light-years, or 239,318 billion miles from Earth in the constellation of Indus. While 55 Cancri E will provide insight into the exotic geology of a world covered in lava, LHSB affords a unique opportunity to analyze the solid rock on an exoplanet surface. Like 55 Cancri E, LHSB orbits extremely close to its star, completing one revolution in 11 hours. However, because its star is relatively small and cool, the planet is not hot enough for the surface to be molten. Additionally, Spitzer observations indicate that the planet is very unlikely to have a substantial atmosphere. While we won't be able to image the surface of LHSB directly with Webb, the lack of an obscuring atmosphere makes it possible to study the surface with spectroscopy. It turns out that different types of rock have different spectra, explained Laura Kreidberg at the Max Planck Institute for Astronomy. You can see with your eyes that granite is lighter in color than basalt. There are similar differences in the infrared light that rocks give off. Kreidberg's team will use MIRI to capture the thermal emission spectrum of the dayside of LHSB, and then compare it to spectra of known rocks, like basalt and granite, to determine its composition. If the planet is volcanically active, the spectrum could also reveal the presence of trace amounts of volcanic gases. The importance of these observations goes far beyond just two of the more than 5,000 confirmed exoplanets in the galaxy. They will give us fantastic new perspectives on Earth-like planets in general, helping us learn what the early Earth might have been like when it was hot like these planets are today, said Kreidberg. These observations of 55 Cancri E and LHSB will be conducted as part of Webb's Cycle 1 General Observers Program. Leave a like, subscribe, and click the bell icon to not miss an update on the James Webb Space Telescope. See you in the next video. Watch this video to know how the first images from the James Webb Space Telescope shocked scientists.